Hi guys, I'm Elle and welcome to Just Irenic. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. Today we'll be covering all the things that happen in sustainable fashion. I think these sections that I'll be covering are super relevant and I think you should be aware of them. So let's get started. So starting off, I want to talk about the Italian denim brand called Replay. So Replay is known for the 360 degree stretch jeans that are called Hyperflex, but recently they've been trying to be more environmentally friendly, so they came out with the Hyperflex Bio. And essentially what this means is that they're making these jeans out of organic cotton, recycled fabric, and PET bottles. And basically what they're trying to do is make a sustainable alternative to their famous jeans. So they've incorporated that 360 degree stretchability from the original design to a more sustainable alternative. The surprising feature is that the sustainable alternative is actually the same price as the normal jeans. So they retail around $200. And according to Replay, the entire capsule is certified according to worldwide sustainability criteria. And they've started doing this by having lower water consumption, by not using any hazardous chemicals, not using any pesticides or OGM seeds, and also using fair trade and also having a wider criteria that includes product safety and worker health in the production cycle. In addition, they've introduced the Hyperflex Reseed, which is a program that will reuse, recycle, and recover wasted resources to manage their environmental impact. The question I have here is, do you think that this collection is simply a way to greenwash us into believing that they're doing the right thing? Do you think there's anything hidden that we should know about? Are you suspicious? I certainly am, and I would love more transparency in how they achieve those prices. So please leave a comment down below if you think this is worth suspicion. So going to the next section, I want to talk about Swarovski's Conscious Design Program and ELB Denim's collaboration. So getting into this, Swarovski has collaborated with ELB Denim to provide an exclusive capsule collection made from 100% upcycled denim and crystal to further promote conscious design. So ELB Denim is actually an East London-based upcycled denim label that holds environmental and social sustainability at the core of its business model. They transform discarded denim into beautiful, sophisticated designs and have zero impact on the environment. And they recently teamed up with Swarovski to create 7 unique pieces that are all individually made by hand. And this partnership is part of Swarovski's Conscious Design Program, which encourages the design community to adopt principles of circularity and to really consider crystals as a part of the upcycling process. The ELB Denim Swarovski collection is actually available already. It was released July 13th and it is located on ELB's Denim's website, with the prices ranging from 650 to £2,200. So getting into the next section, I want to talk about how London Fashion Week recently announced the September dates and how their main focus is sustainability. So from Thursday, September 17th to Tuesday, September 22, London Fashion Week will be hosting all of their events digitally and will be for free. So you'll be able to take a virtual front row seat like any celebrity to all their fashion schedules. When attending these events, bear in mind that they are focusing on the now and on a slower approach to fashion and consumption. This is because this is the first official season that the British Fashion Council and London Fashion Week will be embracing the reset button as a central theme of its positive fashion and hashtag LFW reset initiative. Now I want to talk about the hashtag pay up campaign that's been ongoing since the pandemic started. If you watched my previous video, you may have heard that Levi actually decided to pay up for the orders that their garment workers fulfilled since the pandemic. And this issue has been ongoing as brands haven't wanted to pay for the orders that their garment workers and their factories and suppliers have fulfilled. And basically this week, Gap has finally decided to pay up. Now this is really good news, but every day the ongoing struggle continues. Before filming, Remake actually sent out a notice that TJX, which is a parent company for TJ Maxx, HomeGoods, Marshalls, Sierra, Wieners, HomeSense, and TK Maxx, were added on the list of brands that need to pay up. This only acts as a reminder that we need to hold brands accountable to really pay their garment workers. All the while, news also broke out that Asa, which is the owner of Walmart, has refused to pay their dues to Bangladesh suppliers producing its clothing apparel called George. There is no excuse for Asa not to pay up, since it reported in 2019 that they earned $514.14 billion in revenue. Now keep this in mind, since the George garment workers are only paid $3 per day. And if you don't know what Asa is or what they do, basically they're a UK-based supermarket chain that have remained open since the pandemic. And they have reported the highest volume actually of sales in the pandemic, and yet they're taking a risk in not paying their garment workers because the garment workers are facing homelessness and starvation, and they're really breaching their obligation to pay for these orders. In addition, Asa is refusing to accept up to 20% of orders that suppliers have already shipped to Asa before the pandemic even started. And to make it worse, they're also demanding a 40 to 70% price reduction on orders that were completed but not shipped, and on the in-process orders. So they're essentially demanding a price reduction for goods that were already made, and yet they can't pay their workers because they don't want to. Sounds like a good deal, no? Okay guys, this is the last section I want to cover. Sorry if the camera's angle is slightly off. My computer died, and so I had to reconnect everything. But yeah, so I want to talk about how ThredUp recently launched a collection with Zero Waste Daniel. This collection is actually called Refashion, and it was released July 14th. And basically this collection sells pre-worn clothing that ThredUp considers like new. And they were actually decorated with unsellable scraps that Zero Waste Daniel actually hand sewed onto the garments, and they're like little leaves, so it's pretty cool. And within this collection there will be 200 pieces that includes hoodies, leggings, sweatshirts, and waist pants for a perfect lazy summer at home. And each piece has been hand-sewn by Zero Waste Daniel, and every piece is unique because of that. And the prices range from $13.99 to $59 because each piece is unique with its own work. And basically the goal of this collection is to really bring Zero Waste more into mainstream and to make more of a Zero Waste future, especially because we see so much waste in fast fashion. And yeah, I really approve of this collection, so I give it a big thumbs up, and I definitely recommend that you go check it out if you need anything. And yeah, this has been it for today. Hopefully you enjoy this video. Thank you so much for bearing with this shakiness and with the weird angles throughout the video. Hopefully I'll make better videos in the future. Give this a video a thumbs up if you liked it, and please comment down below what you want to see in the future. I really want to get your feedback. Stay safe. Bye.